its reason. What is the cause of hardness in water? Today we are going to discuss about two things. The first is we are going to discuss about the disadvantages of hard water. Okay, hardness is present in water. It means the water is hard. Okay. Now as we are studying the applied chemistry, so in applied chemistry we have to study about what is the impact of hardness in water. Now what will happen if hardness in water is present? Okay. So we will be looking today in our lecture about the two impacts of hardness at domestic level and at industrial level. It means what will happen, what happens when hardness is present in water and we are using that water in our domestic level, and what will happen if hardness is present in water and what is the effect of that hardness at industrial level. Okay. So very easy topic, interesting too. Let us see. First we will see what happens at domestic level. Okay, if we are using hard water, means hardness is present in water, then if we are using that water in washing utensils, washing clothes, then what will happen? We have to use a lot of soap and we have to continuously rubbing it on cloths, we have to continuously rubbing it on utensils, and still it will not give a good lather. It will leave a white scum or white precipitate. Okay, so it leads to damage of soap, it leads to misuse of soap, lot of amount of soap is used and still we do not get good result. It means our clothes will not be washed properly and our utensils are also not washed properly. Okay, so this is the disadvantage of hardness. Then the second thing, bathing. When we bathe, when we take our bath, what happens? Again we have to use a lot of soap, but still it will not give a good lather. Okay, the soap is used a lot and will not give a good lather. Okay, and when you take the bath, after that you will see that your body becomes sticky, your hairs become sticky. Okay, so this is the problem if you are using hard water while taking a bath. Then we come to cooking. We definitely use water for cooking. Without water we could not cook. Okay, so if we use hard water in cooking, then it leads to elevation in boiling point, and when elevation in boiling points takes place, then what happens? It takes large amount of fuel to cook. Okay, and time also required very high. Lot amount of time is required, lot amount of fuel is wasted, and still our whatever you are cooking pulses, you are cooking rice, then it will not be cooked properly. Okay. Then drinking, if we talk about drinking, then daily we need 3 to 4 liters of water for our drinking purpose, and if the water is hard, then what happens? It affects our digestive system. It means the digestion of food in our body do not take properly. Okay, the second thing you must have heard about stone, pathri. Okay, so that is also the problem. If you are consuming hard water and if hardness is present in water, then the stones are calcium oxalate crystals. Those are deposited in our urinary tract, and so many people are suffering with this problem of pathri, or you can say stone in urinary tract. Okay, so all these are the problems of using hard water in our domestic level. Okay, that is why you have seen that people are using ROs, people are using softeners in their homes to get rid of this hardness. Okay, now we'll come to industrial level. At industrial level also hardness is a big problem. Okay, and you have seen I have listed so many industries. Other than this, many industries are there in which hardness causing problems. Let us see some of the industries. First one is textile industry. If you are preparing clothes, then again it takes it is needing the soap to wash the textiles. And again the soap, lot amount of soap is wasted, and still the textiles are not cleaned properly. Okay, then in sugar industry, the sugar form, if we are using hard water, then the sugar form is deliquescent type. Deliquescent means ghee sugar banti, proper crystallization of the sugar do not take place. Okay, if hardness is present in water. Okay, Then we'll come to dyeing industry. You must have heard about tie and dye industries, na, where the clothes are being dyed, they are being colored. Okay? And you know, dyes are chemicals. So chemicals are used to dye the clothes. So what happens if hardness is present in water? The hardness reacts with the dye or chemical and it leads to some other type of color. The colors are also not very sharp. Okay? And the cloth after the production is also not very soft and glossy. The same thing is with paper industry also. The papers, if we are using hard water, then the papers are not glossy, the paper are not of good quality, and if some iron salts are present in water, then it will lead to the change in color of also the paper. It will not be pure white, it will be near about what you can say, muddy white like that. Now, next is concrete making. You must have heard about concretes. Okay? So, concrete, if in preparing the concrete we are using hard water, then also the hardness leads to the concrete that will be formed after it will not set properly. Okay? So, it also causes problem. Then, pharmaceutical industries, if we talk about pharmaceutical industries, then we have to use distilled water. Distilled water means not even a single molecule of hardness should be present in water, and if it is present, then it will lead to some other type of drug. Na? The constitution of drug will be disrupted. Okay, so in pharmaceutical industries, we could not use hard water. Na? Not even a single hardness is to be used in water. Then comes steam generation in boilers. Okay. Boilers, you must have heard, they are big utensils, you can say. They are big tanks in which the water is boiled for steam generation. Okay. Now, if hardness is present in water that is to be used in the boiler, then what happens? Continuously that water will be boiled and it will leave the hardness on the tank. And if this process goes on continuously, then what will happen? So many type of boiler troubles are arised. Okay. So in our coming class, we will be considering this only. Huh? This is the main part of our chapter, steam generation in boiler. Now, what problems are caused if we use hard water in boilers? Okay? So many boiler troubles are there, which we will be discussing in our next class. Okay? So this is the end of our today's class, in which we have seen what are the disadvantages of hard water. Two advantages are also there. We will be discussing in our next class. Okay, till then, have a nice day.